I have therefore decided to raise the level of influenza pandemic alert from phase 5 to phase 6. The world is now at the start of the 2009 influenza pandemic.
Dr. Margaret Chan, who's in charge of the World Health Organization, finally raised the pandemic level to level 6, which is as high as it gets. A WHO pandemic is when you have a sustained human-to-human community transmission of a virus in two regions, which practically means two continents. And so once it broke out of Mexico and the United States and Canada and was seen turning up in Britain and then Spain and then Japan and then Australia and then Chile, it became pretty clear that this virus is spreading around the world and there's no stopping it.
As of today, nearly 30,000 confirmed cases have been reported from 74 countries.
The statement sounds very dramatic. Dr. Margaret Chan said the pandemic has begun, we're all in this together. But the truth is, by a WHO definition, the pandemic probably began weeks ago. But the WHO was afraid of spreading panic. And by panic, they were afraid that, you know, even though the whole world knows about the disease, they were afraid that countries would close borders or declare quarantines or do other things that it considers unnecessary. And in fact, they're right. That's going on. Egypt was just quarantined a couple of Americans, and China is quarantined. So these unnecessary, in effect, panicky things are going around the world. So some of the WHO's concern was legitimate. At the same time, they've been in a struggle because their pandemic alert levels was written when everybody thought it was going to be H5N1, the bird flu. The bird flu has killed about 60% of the people who got it. So they're imagining that any human-to-human spread is going to be wildly lethal, when in fact now we've got a disease that nobody quite knows how many people it kills. It seems to only give severe cases to about 2% of the people who get it. But it's when the virus hits Africa, when it hits some of the poorer countries of the world, it's going to be much worse. One doesn't know how much worse, and there's not much information about how the flu behaves in the tropical parts of the world, and very little information or surveillance on how it behaves in the poorest parts of the world. So there's still a lot of unknowns out there. What's next is a lot of watching and waiting. I mean, now we're in a full-blown pandemic of a relatively mild virus. Now, what could happen next is the virus could stop being mild. It could become no less mild, but it could become Tamiflu resistant, which means that for those people who have serious cases, suddenly Tamiflu doesn't do any good. Scientists don't consider those terribly likely.
We are all in this together. And we will all get through this together.
For the New York Times, I'm Donald G. McNeil, Jr.